What's going on, everyone? SnoopLoop7 here, bringing you a Call of Duty Ghosts domination gameplay on the map Freight, where I go 40-7, cut out the first minute or so, had like 3 deaths there at the start, wasn't doing too good, so I'm just going to leave that out. But anyway, I captured this gameplay with an Elgato Game Capture HD. So yes, that means I have upgraded to the Elgato from the Hapage USB Live 2 capture card, which is similar to a Dazzle, if you know what that is. It's Friday right now when I'm recording this. Hopefully it'll go up Friday or Saturday at the latest. I actually wanted to put this video up on Tuesday because the Elgato arrived from Amazon on Monday, but unfortunately there was a snowstorm, so it kind of messed up the mailing at my school, so it didn't actually get to my dorm until late Tuesday afternoon. So the middle of my week is kind of crammed with class and stuff, so I haven't actually been able to do anything with it until today, so I'll try and get this video up as soon as possible. But what this means is that I will now be able to record and upload real 720 HD footage. And yes, all my other videos are technically 720 HD, but there are 480p recordings upscaled into 720. So it was really like a diluted version of 720 HD. And the process of making the videos was much longer than what's going to be now. Because basically, with the Hapage USB Live 2, it's a simple $50 capture card that only records in 480p, and I would use a program to capture a very large, uncompressed AVI file. I would then compress the file to make it smaller, then I'd have to use some filters to crop the footage and resize it from 480 to 720. Then I would have to extract the audio file from the video and then add my own commentary onto that, and then re-add the combined audio back into the video, and then I could save it and upload it. And even though it was 720, it was a really, like, a poor man's 720. Like, it looked better than if I uploaded the 480, but not nearly as good as this 720 looks. And I could technically even record and upload in 1080 with the Elgato now, but that would make the file a little bit bigger and take a little longer to upload to YouTube, and I don't always have that time. But if I ever wanted to, I do have the ability to even upload in 1080. But this real 720 looks plenty better than the fake 720 I had been uploading in, so if you weren't already watching in HD, and if you have good enough internet to, watch this in 720 because it looks way better. But yeah, it's just way easier to make videos now. I just record it, slap on the commentary, and it's ready to upload. Live commentaries are also going to be much easier as well. I used to record the video and my voice separately, and then I'd have to try and sync them up by myself. And that was always a pain because it was really just guesswork. But with the Elgato, I can record them simultaneously in the same program and I don't have to sync them myself. So that's another plus to it. And another awesome thing about the Elgato is that it allows me to record N64 gameplay. The N64 and other old consoles put out in such a low resolution that many capture cards, including the one I had been using, they can't recognize it and so you can't record it. But with the Elgato, I can, so that's good news for the gaming memory series. I'll be able to record some classic games. I had already done the Super Smash Bros. One, which I had recorded just my TV screen with a camera. Obviously, it looks bad, so I'm going to be able to re-record Super Smash Bros., just put the audio on this new video I'm going to make, and just re-upload it. So there's definitely some cool things I can do now. I could even live stream on Twitch if I wanted to. I do have a Twitch account, but I've never actually live streamed on it because in the past, obviously, I would have only been able to stream in 360p quality, and it just wouldn't have looked good at all. So now that I could stream in 720, that's something I'd be able to do in the future. And look at this host migration right here. Dudes be rage quitting, man. Luckily, the guy in front of me didn't rage quit. I was able to get him. I think I was on at least a 15 kill streak at this point in the game. I had a battle hind now. Guard dog with a guard dog on deck. I was getting hella guard dogs this game. But anyway, I'll still need the cheap capture card at certain times because I don't have an HD TV at home, only at my dorm room. So if I ever went home for a weekend and for some reason I needed to record something, I'd still be able to use that. And the fact that I have an HD TV at school is one of the big reasons why I decided to get an Elgato, because the HD TV only has video in, it doesn't have video out. So that means I have to use splitters to try and record and play at the same time. So I basically have to connect the Xbox directly to the capture card, and then from there split it back to the TV, and that absolutely kills the quality. Not the quality of the video, but the quality of what I'm seeing on the TV makes it really grainy and really difficult to play. It's pretty hard to see anybody when you're trying to play with the splitters. So being able to play in HD and still record in HD is just a huge plus. And luckily, if I ever do have to record on my house, my standard definition TV has video in and video out, so that means I can just connect my Xbox to my TV, and then my TV to my capture card, so it doesn't really affect the quality of what I'm seeing or affect the recording quality. Obviously, though, it's not in HD, and I have to upscale that. And again in the gameplay, running around with a guard dog at my side, with another guard dog waiting to get called into battle. And I actually rarely use the guard dog, because usually my lowest kill streak is the Trinity rocket or the sentry gun that I run. Got another Trinity right here, but this dude coming up right here in a second with the snipes, this guy got me a couple times. Really grinding my gears, throwing me off my streaks. But yeah, not much else really happens in the gameplay. And one more thing that I haven't mentioned yet, not everything is going to be Elgato recordings just yet, because I still have stuff that's already recorded from the prior method that I'm still waiting to upload, so next couple weeks is going to be a mix of both types of recordings, and I'll be working my way into bigger and better things with the Elgato, so I'm definitely excited about that. And that about wraps it up here. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe for newer and better things to come, and I'll see you next time. Peace.